Well, welcome, comrades from the media. Well, the Politburo is still on, so but we thought that we've kept you here in the past for too late, and we don't want you to file your stories at midnight. But I've decided that I should give you what we've covered, and I think we've covered almost everything. The other things can be under another business. Let me start by saying that His Excellency the President and First Secretary, Comrade R.I.G. Mugabe, welcomed members of the Politburo and called the 311th ordinary session to order. He further wished the meeting successful deliberations. Comrade Joseph Made, in his capacity as Minister of Agriculture, Mechanization and Irrigation Development, gave a comprehensive report on the state of agriculture in the country. He stated that the 2016-2017 agricultural season has recorded an increase in both crop and livestock production. A bumper harvest has been recorded in both food and cash crops. The country will not be importing food this time around, as we have a surplus. For the 2017-2018 season, the various agricultural programs will be expanded threefold. On the presidential agricultural well-wishers' inputs, we shall be distributing maize and small graze inputs covering 1.8 million households. B, soybeans inputs also covering 1.8 million households. And C, cotton inputs 400,000 households. Command Agriculture is on course and is receiving many enthusiastic applicants for this season. This will, of course, in terms of Command Agriculture, include maize, soybeans, wheat, fruit trees, livestock, fisheries, and wildlife. Jerome Gumbo, who is Secretary for Education in the party, in his capacity as Minister of Transport and Infrastructural Development, gave a comprehensive report on rehabilitation of roads throughout the country. All councils are being funded by Zinara. Those which have not been funded have not acquitted the funds they were given in the previous financial period. You know, councils have so many roads as well. That is the position. A loan facility has been acquired from Afro Exim Bank for the upgrade of Harare International Airport. Victoria Falls, Kariba, and Mutare airports
will also be rehabilitated. The National Railways of Zimbabwe, NRSX, will also be rehabilitated. Comrade Gumbo was hopeful that a partner to resuscitate Air Zimbabwe was still being sought. But he believes that this won't be long. We also received an update report on the Presidential Youth Interface. The Secretary of the Youth League, Comrade Kudzanai Chipanga, gave a brief report on the Presidential Youth Interface rallies. He thanked the party leadership for their support and informed Politburo that the next interface, which will be the 8th rally, will be held on 9 September 2017 in Bindura, Mashonaland Central. The Secretary for Administration, Comrade Ignatius Chombo, briefed the Politburo on the state of preparations for the 17th National People's Conference. The conference will be held in Gwanda, Mat South Province, of course, in December. Preparations are going on very well, and various committees have been activated to carry specific duties to these preparations. The identification of delegates has begun with a total of 6,500 party members expected to attend the conference. Finalization of the venue in Gwanda itself is to be concluded with semi-D grounds and the Gwanda showgrounds being possible venues, one of them. The National Political Commissar, Comrade Kasukwere, Xavier Kasukwere, gave a comprehensive report on the activities of the party throughout the country. The party structures are alive and well. Unity, of course, is no doubt the key to ZANU-PF sweeping next year's elections. We also received a report from the National Disciplinary Committee which is chaired by Comrade Patrick Namasa, Secretary for Legal Affairs in the party. He, of course, presented a report on outstanding disciplinary cases. After deliberations, the following was the outcome. Provincial Women's League executive members of Mashonaland East Province. Provincial Women's League executive members of Mashonaland East Province. Comrade Apollonia Muzwerengi and Comrade Petronila Kagonye. These two members will revert to ordinary card-carrying members, and they will not be restored to their previous positions. Two, this is Masuala Central, Comrade Dixon Mafios. The ruling is that the vote of no confidence imposed on him by the province is null and void, and thus he shall continue in his position as provincial chairperson of Mashallah and Central. The same shall apply to Wanda Mashange. Whose vote of no confidence was also considered null and void, and thus he shall continue as the provincial secretary for administration for Mashallah and Central. Six members of the Manicaland Provincial Youth League executive. Actually, these are not six, three. Kelvin Manyekavana, Gertrude Mutandi, and Washington Ziwiwiwi. Ziwiwi. Washington Ziwiwi. The votes of no confidence on them are null and void, and these members will continue to enjoy full rights of membership. Notwithstanding this, the National Disciplinary Committee recommended, and it was accepted, that the trio shall not be restored to their positions, previous positions, as these have already been filled. Five, Comrade Obed Msindo, Youth League, Bulawayo Province. The ruling on him was that vote of no confidence is null and void, and will continue in his position as Provincial Deputy Secretary for Indigenization. Six, National Youth League members. Comrade Louis Matutu, Secretary for Administration, and Comrade Sibongile Sibanda, Deputy Secretary for Administration. Vote of no confidence was upheld, and the two lose their positions and revert to ordinary card-carrying members. Seven, Bulawayo Province Youth League Executive. Comrade Leo Nyoni and Comrade Makawe Sibanda. The ruling on the vote of no confidence is null and void. The two will continue to serve in their positions. Eight, Comrade Patience Dapoma. Patience Dapoma. The ruling is that full rights of membership be restored, but cannot revert to her former position as this has already been filled. Nine, Comrade J.P. Jabun, the ruling on the vote of no confidence is that it is null and void, and he shall continue in his position as Provincial Commissar for Masingo Province. Ten, acts of misconduct by members who attended a war veterans meeting also addressed this meeting, that is, by Jaulani Sivanda. These are the following. In Bulawayo. Comrade Angeline Masuku, Comrade Opa Nube, Comrade Eliphas Chuma, Comrade Molim Pofu, Comrade Christopher Sivanda, Comrade Rose Candiero, Comrade Charles Njovu, Comrade Rejoice Sivanda, Comrade Cecilia Verenga, and Comrade Garikai Zonde. The vote of no confidence on them is null and void, and members of the National Consultative Assembly from the above will continue as members. The others whose positions have not been filled will be restored to their positions. Eleven, Manicaland Province suspensions. Comrade Enoch Orusingazi and Comrade John Chirimambowa, the suspension of the two members has been lifted. Suspension has been lifted. 12, it's again deliberations on suspension orders. Shirati Zamukarati, Harare Province. Goodwill Masimerabwa, Harare Province. Deni Musukuma, Harare Province. Happiness Nyakuyedzwa, this one I think is Manicaland Province. Suspensions have been lifted and members will revert to ordinary card carrying membership. Last but not least, 13, Comrade Mabel Chinomona, case has been debated at length, and the conclusion by the Politburo is that she has been relieved of her duties in the Women's League. I think she was commissar. The Women's League. She has been relieved of her post in the Women's League. That is the end of my statement. Too long.